Let's see the damage. Let's see the damage. So, how does this work? We got graphic session. We need to okay. Oh, I don't actually have a VK requirement for that at all. But I do for the other thing. Render target. Yes. Can I just like have these for two. Candidate cannot convert initializer list from that to that. Can I just say like that? No. Yeah, okay. DelayedDestructor needs to be called every time we're doing one of these. So swap chain, we have a new frame, we're going to do it. Because this frame is, yeah. Okay, new session. Like, what is GTHR default? Why can you never find it? Whatever. Great, we got a bunch of stuff. Great, yes. Basically nothing to go wrong there. Yeah, okay. Oh, that's right. I need these to actually have. Equals what, 3? We'll just say 3 of each for the moment, right? I need to be able to return if these things don't have. That should be 6. Correct. We gotta go through this. We're gonna have 6 of these. Not image count though, that's not correct. It's wrong. We just want count. Okay. We'll have to go down to the frame buffer. So that is something that will be delayed. Okay, we destroyed that one. Now we need to create the new frame buffer with the items that we're using right now. So, need to reset the offset to be 0. Creating frame buffers. Remind me, how did I do this? That's actually where I am right now. That's not very useful. Okay, here we go. We got these are the attachments. Compatible render pass. Oh man. So the attachments I have, the extent I have, I just need to import the render pass. I can either get it from externally, which I'm going to do for now. No, I don't want to do that. But I can do it when I create it, right? Because I will know what the compatible render pass is based on the formats and the samples I get when I'm creating the render target in the first place. So I can do that. So I need, what do I need? What is this? Faux render pass pool. Okay, I need a, since the spec isn't changing, I can get it at the start and keep a hold onto it. VK render pass. Compatible render pass. Okay, this is okay. After this weekend, I'm going to do something light. Like, I'm going to convert the render pass pool to something more graphics oriented. I'm going to update it because it's pretty still original and still embedded in the top level graphics with a lot of Vulkan specific items going on. very Vulkan specific items going on. Probably meaning I'll have to like bump it down to graphics VK and maybe integrate it into the session. Because maybe like I may just want to have some session pools for the moment before I split them out for a future reason. But until I need to, I should really not. But again, we actually make it add it to the list. Do that. Back to here. I got that. If that's the case, then I'm going to return do I have error codes? I do not have actually my own error codes for this yet. I really need to fix that right away. It's just more and more stuff. It just keeps happening. Keep having to branch out. Who has a good implementation? Graphics VK actually, or the resource does, right? You should, yeah. Got that. Okay, an hour and a half. Pause for drink. Okay. This didn't work. Why? No matching function to call. Why? Also, I need to finish up the error code, right? Error code, I was going to use this for a render target in here, so yes, because this isn't done yet. So I need to include. or whatever this is, this long string error code, and we got like okay, we got that. So, we've got image specifications, p delayed, under targets, so compatible, after image specifications. Compatible render pass. We now have a compatible render pass I can use when generating frame buffers. So back to the original render target system. Now I gotta go through each of these. No, I don't. Rather, I can get what I need while I'm rolling through these. Images. Place back. Image dot view. Okay. We come back down here, destroy the old frame buffer, create new frame buffer. Yeah, this. That's the same, that's the same, about that. Okay. Here we have to pass in the render pass to that. Okay, we got those things. Now I do have maintenance, and I also want to up here somewhere. Render to image. Test target. Yeah, this stuff. So where do I update it? Is it way up here? Yeah. No, no. Acquire next. Render target. Do I just not have like error codes in here whatsoever? I have XRN program right there. So what? Okay. Let's see how badly this doesn't work. So indices are currently 1 and 1, that's fine. Oh, I don't update the offset. I do not update the offset between these. I did not update the extent either. I need that to be set. Okay, roll through again. Okay, this pre-render target now has an extent, which is real. Images, they're all false, as they should be. Has, I presume, a valid thing. Image specifications, there's two of them. There's two indices, they're set to one. Okay, go through. It's not latest. So then, oh, we also need to. Set that. Okay. So now I'm here. Okay. This is now like some garbage. Okay. So what happened? What happened is my attempt to be a smartass. And trying to do this completely and utterly failed. This was fine because it only had one list and I tried to expand it. Okay. So we now have a new list. Okay. Oh, yes, because I moved it over, didn't I? Also, this should be different, shouldn't it? This should be the next one. Crap. Lovely. An actual terrible memory leak. Acquire our next thing. We do that. Go inside of here. We got a problem. Okay. You know what? Let's just do this. Okay, hold on. It's current on 3, num delayed 3, so that makes sense. Then we move up, so it should go to the beginning. That's great. That'll be the one that we moved over. 1 and then 0. Oh, I have to do the thing like if. Num delayed equals fn lists dot size, then I can just add it. Otherwise, I need to do this. I can just add it straight to the current list like that. Right? I can just do that regardless. Because if it's just gonna roll right to the same item anyway. So fn list. Okay, if not equal, run that. Otherwise, this. Okay, it worked for a little while. Yeah, okay. A little while being the thing. Invalid frame buffer object, Vulcan. If it's not, it must be a valid handle. Okay. So this happened, what, inside a choir? Was there an error elsewhere? Loading shaders in parallel. Okay, that's stuff. Jitter in new pipeline. And then we get this. Interesting. First time through, this should be null. It is after all empty. Okay. We'll then create the frame buffer. It is now that 56. Great. Come back through. Okay. Until it does eventually run into a case where it is trying to delete. Interesting. This is happening inside the running of the delayed thing, right? Yeah. Like, what's going on? Is calls to run There's one call in there. Call range, calls to run. P delayed, function lists. There's something to do in three, but there should be like one in each, in all three, shouldn't there? Like, when would I have otherwise deleted this one? So, okay, let's go to the first deletion. Okay. We deleted what was... Okay. B8. C2. Why? I'm not even using them. I'm just... Okay, let's be really aggressive with logs then. See if I can accidentally get like I'm the fact that I'm I must be deleting two in a row or something by accident somehow. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then these two I'm deleting twice. Why am I deleting this one twice? Why? I'm not calling this twice, am I? Is this a me issue? I only have one call in existence. I only go through this once. And then I reset it at the end as well. Do I have a case where I'm rerunning, like run... once. And that happens first. Lambda capture. Is it because I have, it must be because I'm using the pointer. It must be like capturing the pointer rather than the actual like end object that I'm looking for. It must be captures. Okay, it must be capturing the pointer rather than the actual pointed to object. That's gotta be it, I'm hoping. I don't see another way around for this to be happening. Do that, and we have let's see if there's a mismatch between those two when I'm doing this as well. So stop that, rebuild, rerun. Yeah, here we go. You see, this is the problem. Wah, 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 wah. Failure on my part. It sets at B94 for a couple times before it's the one that's actually to be deleted. Oh, good. You can't even like search through the list. How fantastically useful. I love it. Oh no, that's the only case. What? What do you mean that's the only case? Unless it was one that just came through so quickly. Okay, whatever. Fixed. Copying the pointer, not the pointer to object. Of course, of course. Okay, let's see if I can actually get this stuff out now. That was the entire point of this in the first place. So VK framebuffer. got that. So spit that out. That's great. And then I need to be able to spit out the image for a resolve. The image. Okay, go to declaration of that. I need to include need to do that, right? Like for these, yeah. This requires a little bit of fun. Corn going up. Less than index. So I need to return p render target images offset plus p render target indices I that offset or index. Dot image. So I need to go not swap image. Stuff up here. This can also be moved later. Test target frames. Okay, this is what I'm looking for. So I want to get this staged. So don't accidentally wreck things. I'm going to say, hey, photographicsvk render target frame buffer for. Off screen for the moment. There's that test target. So for that, I need the samples. Okay, the resolve, which required, now I need the image. And it's for image index 0. So got that, deinitialize, I've got the spec formats up here. I'm wondering if this will actually just work straight up. I mean, these will be the same. Using the same spec, please tell me. Doesn't look like it. Looks like it's about to crash. No, it's not going to crash, but I do have other items. I have problems with the frame buffers. Yeah, accidentally deleting a frame buffer before I should be, which is odd. Okay, all submitted commands that cannot call destroy on the frame buffer that is currently in use by a command buffer. The Vulkan spec states all submitted commands that refer must have completed execution. But by now, by the time I get back to this one, it should have been safe. One, two. What if we do plus one? Is it just because it's rolling back onto itself? It should have been, by the time it comes back, okay, not correct. Something to delayed construction call. So we need to come into here. Great. First time we're adding something. Right now there's the function list is not there. We have one. Locking it. We do unlock at the end, yes. So we do that, we swap it around, great, we're here. There's nothing in here, and then we're going to add something. Currently look sitting and pointing at this last one, right? Which means I should be adding it to number 5. Okay. Then when we're coming through here to run delayed, yeah, there's nothing in there quite yet. Function list is still number 5. We're looking at this one, we're incrementing it, so now it's looking at some, that's at the end, it's going to sit back to the front. Then we're back to this one. Which should. Now it's empty. That's the thing we're about to run, right? We unlock that. And now we run the delayed call. And we're good. Okay, just whoop. Okay. It just seemed to be fine. Like it is properly delaying the destruction by 6 times, 6 frames. Right, and it is being called on the 6th frame, right? Delayed destructor. We wait for frame, yes. Maybe I should be doing it down here. Where do I do the graphics? Oh, maintenance. I do them here. Let's try it here. That is fine. Okay. So why is this section firing off way more times than it should be? I waited for the fence. Okay, something is wrong with my render loop somehow. I do wait for the VK fence for it to be success, which means it did. The fence has been completed. Am I just not like frame complete? Am I looking at the incorrect frame or whatever? So I'm now using the new, okay, I'm new now using the new render target, which means I can start scrapping the old. Correct. Scrap those. Actually, I should do this from this point. So we scrap that. They're gone. Scrap that. These are gone. That and that. Okay. Not cool. Apparently, I'm not sure what exactly is going on here. Formats are the same, yeah. Okay. Okay, that's all I have. So, not going to crap out, right? It's going to be okay. It's fine. It's perfectly fine. Okay. Do I do something here? No. Only when I do maintenance with it as okay. Get rid of this target system. We still good? Oh, I know what it is. This is supposed to be D16. Get rid of these. Get rid of these. And it's perfectly fine. Let's move the new frame around. Because it feels to me like something is very wrong right there. If it's there when it should be here, I guess. Okay, that looks a bit better. It's a lot more stable. We can do that at least. We'll move the frame time around. I just don't know. So let's add some things. We add delay destructor. That one and that one and that. That is it, in a nutshell, really. Okay, and then I need to kind of create this a bit better than what I have right now. So close all, just close everything. Close everything, go open this again. And then we need the application HPP side as well. So graphics session runtime upload context. We also need the I don't know why these aren't showing up as new, but okay. So I need to create a delay destructor up in the initialization, graphics runtime, graphics session, load context. Call it from that with error. And make tuple. Yeah, okay. Similar towards the end on deinitialization. Destroy that. Okay, let's add that then. So we got delayed destructor, great. This delayed destructor, stage that. The initialization of it. Actually, if realistically, I want to do the same thing on that, but later. Wait, hold on. Wait a second. Did I accidentally already put? Okay. When did I make these modifications? Close that. Where is it hiding in here? It's hiding in here. File history. I added basically everything, and I didn't want to do that. Okay. Okay, undo last commit. We are going to unset all of that. Instead, we're just going to be moving just this, get stage that, and the one call to that, stage that. That's it, right? That is it, just two things. Wonderful, put that in. Okay. Great, there we are. We are now back where I was hoping to be in the first place. Almost there, 2.5 hours on this one. Almost there. So, what was I doing? Application, yes. Delayed destruction, great. On to here, delayed destruction, yes, great, I like it. Down here, delayed destruction stuff. Yes, great, I love it. Doesn't have to be here. Nope, yes. Okay. Finally, the render target. Render target, we'll do this, move it from there in up to here, we're also going to have UK format, D16 for the moment. the XR stuff. Graphic session, that, put it here. Off screen specs is that. We got that, and that. Okay. I'm going to require this up here. I come down here, we have an error code. Color format is going to be, where do I create the window? I create the window there. Oh no, I don't know if it's that at this point, because I don't actually like create the first swap chain. I don't determine this until down here. Is it still part of the initialization? Or where is it? Okay, I do it down here. I still do it up here somewhere, so I can still do this. I just have to make sure it's swap chain formats. Swap chains, CI, this is for XR, okay. I don't know the format beforehand. Garbage. What garbage? All right, I'm going to. It's 2 hours, 40 minutes. I'm going to end this here and kind of complete it offline, or I'll do a little bit of a thing tomorrow morning when I rested again. All right, cheers. Okay, and now I'm back. Now, on to. Last thing I was dealing with was render target. Yes. Being after, yes, this having to be after swap chain creation. Now, I don't do swap chain creation here. So what I can do, what I'm going to bet that I can do, is I don't have to do this here, but I can do it on the first pass of this. Now, somewhere up here is the first time I do, like, if no swap chain, then we need to create the surface in presentation mode. And then I need to create these. The off-screen spec. Error code and program, that's great. Auto error code. And this is going to be not from that. Well, that's actually going to have to be that, but... So what I'm going to do is depth format is going to equal this. this is going to equal swap chain dot surface format dot format. Max supported samples is set where? Here, after we do this. That might be enough. Okay, we've got one format and it's just for the depth type. But at this point, I don't have I don't have it at this point. But I will have it after swap chain. I need to run this. And then it's okay, so it's still set after the swap chain. This happens on the first run every time, anyways. Okay. Okay, so what's going on here? Trying to destroy frame buffer, must be a valid frame buffer handle. What's happening? When I'm destroying, okay, hold on, when I destroy, that's what I'm doing, isn't it? I'm doing it right away, aren't I? Do I not have a destroy? Do I not have a destroy for this? Update. I have create. Update. Acquire. I don't actually have a destroy for this. Wow, how did I mess that up? Okay. Like I must have. I don't. I actually don't. Okay. Get the render target. I'm gonna go do I want to do a delayed destruction on these things? I don't think I do. I'll just immediately destroy. What can I immediately destroy? I can't do it for images. No, there are some images. Okay, I can only do it for images that are set as not latest, perhaps, or hold on. Anything that's in the array right now will be. I'm assuming that at this point I've completely finished using it entirely, if I'm destroying it. So I can actually work under the assumption that all images and the current frame buffer can be destroyed right away. So we'll do that. So image event target. Actually no, let's do frame buffers first. Session device p render target frame buffer and null pointer for the allocator. Lovely. Auto constant image. Image dot view. Okay. Here, I need to add like destruction of this. Destroy frame buffers. So we'll just kind of do that here. And we need to say, if. Wait, didn't I already have this? I swear I already had this. Oh, I have it for delayed destructor. Just sitting right above. What is the order I have this? Delayed destructor, so this happens before that. Okay, I'm interested in why this happened. If we're going fine, then we quit, and then we have an error. Right on this one. From the delayed destructor, calling everything. I think I'm running through this twice, perhaps. That's the problem. I start on this one. I start on the next one. And I come through. Well, call this not equal that. Current list. Okay, so this has got to be a problem with this instead. So what are we going to do? I'm going to function lists. I want to find out which index it starts on, and I'm going to watch the index as it goes through. It calls them. What if I was to like oh yeah, I see what's going on. I'm not incrementing the call list. I'm going through. I do it for the other ones, right? The do while loop? No, I do not. How on earth did this work? Oh no, it only worked because I only started on one. So I came back to the same one. Yes. Okay. Maybe not. Something else is wrong now. And I. What? Oh no, yeah, because the do while loop, I increment it so it's never actually this again. So what I really should do is do this equals that. I increment it, check that. Then I come back through until I re-hit this one. One of these days I'll know. I don't know what I was thinking last night. Must have really been in a bad state. Far too much time. It's almost 3 hours, 4 hours straight. Yeah, I guess I can conceive of issues. Okay, here we go. We're back on. Great. We can't clear out correctly. That's great. DelayedDestructor. That. Close that. Close that. Render target. Render target items. Render target fix up. Okay, application. Back to this. Render target. We have that and a couple of other items. Great. And how do we got render? We don't need that one. Or do we? The Vulcan one we do, yeah. Max supported, okay. Go down this the deinitialization. Creating the render target. Updating render target for swap chains. New swap chains, yeah. Acquiring the next render target, okay. Adding the sample flag to these things. Setting that to by default be one. Load present, okay. There's no good way of laying that out, so just lay it out like that, I guess. I need a case for when render target and resolve have sample count of 1, because this is always assuming it's resolving down. It may not be. And I need to be ready for that. Let's see if I can maneuver some things around a bit more. So swap chain rebuilt. I have this. This doesn't really need to be here. Or the here. Render off screen. Blah da blah blah da blah. Then we get to here. becomes this. Because we are rendering to this afterwards. Six milliseconds a frame? That's kind of high for not doing much. Of course, it could always be the case of MSAA. So 0.6, and then if I set it down to like just VK sample count 2, so just double sampling. Does that make much of a difference? Basically none at all. Yep, the hardware acceleration sure works on that. So, or the problem is elsewhere. Maybe CPU issues. It's CPU bound right now. I mean, that would make sense. Like maybe. Oh well. Swap chain rebuilt. So this works. So that. Okay, let's just. That's still good. This is good. Acquiring and then new sample count flags makes sense. New samples. Hold on. Oh, the samples was given in that way, yeah. Faux XR, the XR, oh yeah, I also need to update. XR for render targets. I'm just happy with the whole thing right now. All right, then I gotta, after this, I gotta clean up some details, such as I gotta do the XR and the resolve target if the same, has the same sample count. And then I need 11 the swap chain image usage flags. And then I got an F all the way back there. That's not good. log one line, okay. So that'll cap off the nonsense from last time. And then I'll have another session after this to clean up, added to XR, sample count, resolve nonsense. And then that'll be it. So cheers for now. Cheers for now.